Music as an art form is essentially play. Say, you play the piano, work the piano. Why? Music differs from, say, travel. When you travel, you are trying to get something. And of course, we, because being a very compulsive and purposive culture, are busy getting everywhere faster and faster and faster till we eliminate the distance between places. I mean, with the modern jet travel, you can arrive almost instantaneously. What happens as a result of that is that the two ends of your journey become the same place. So you eliminate the distance. You eliminate the journey. Because the fun of the journey is not to obliterate the journey. So then, in music, though, one doesn't make the end of a composition. If that were so, the best conductors would be those who played fastest. And there would be composers who wrote only finales. People go to concert just to hear one crashing chord, because that's the end. Same way in dancing. You don't aim at a particular spot in the room. That's where you should arrive. The whole point of the dancing is the dance. Now, but we don't see that as something brought by our education into our everyday conduct. We've got a system of schooling that gives a completely different impression. It's all graded. And what we do is we put the child into the corridor of this grade system with a kind of, come on, kitty, kitty, kitty. And yeah, you go to kindergarten. That's a great thing, because when you finish that, you'll get into first grade. And then, come on, first grade leads to second grade, and so on, and then you get out of grade school, you go to high school, and it's revving up, the thing is coming. Then you're going to go to college, and by Jove, then you get into graduate school, and when you're through with graduate school, you go out to join the world. Then you get into some racket where you're selling insurance, and they've got that quota to make, and you're going to make that. And all the time, the thing is coming. It's coming, it's coming, that great thing, the success you're working for. Then when you wake up one day about 40 years old, you say, my God, I've arrived. I'm there. And you don't feel very different from what you always felt. And there's a slight letdown because you feel there's a hoax. And there was a hoax, a dreadful hoax. They made you miss everything by expectation. Look at the people who live to retire. You put those savings away. And then when they're 65, they don't have any energy left, they're more or less impotent, and they go and rot in an old people's, senior citizens' community. Because we've simply cheated ourselves the whole way down the line. We thought of life by analogy with a journey, with a pilgrimage, which had a serious purpose at the end, and the thing was to get to that end. Success or whatever it is, or maybe heaven after you're dead. But we missed the point the whole way along. It was a musical thing. It was shows to sing or dance while music was being played. So then, this is, as I've said, my basic metaphysical assumption. It existed in music.
Just 16 and the people were mean, so they didn't love themselves, and now they're gone, headstones on a wall. And when I was younger, I knew a boy and a boy, best friends with each other, but always wish they were, cause they loved one another, but but never discovered, cause they were too afraid what they'd say. Proved to different states. Oh, and I'm afraid that's just the way the world works. It ain't funny, it ain't pretty, it ain't sweet. Oh, and I'm afraid that's just the way the world works. But I think that it could work for you and me. Just wait and see. It's not the end of the story. Now it's on to the sequel about me and my friend. Both our parents were evil, so we both made a bet. If we worked and we saved, we could both run away and we fly.
So I let the music just take control, cause it's